If you're using an autofocuser, there's a good chance that you're going to need backlash compensation. And I'm going to show you precisely how much you need right now. What's up? I'm Alan, and I've been doing astrophotography for years. Beginner astrophotographers enter this hobby full of frustration. By understanding how to maximize your equipment, you can start taking awesome images with little hassle. If this is your first time here and you're interested in learning more about astrophotography, start now by clicking the subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss a thing. Autofocusers make life easy because we can keep our system in focus without having to touch the telescope. But like with any geared system, there's always going to be backlash present. And autofocus programs need to know how much to compensate for. If you stick around for the next few minutes, I'll show you how to precisely measure how much backlash is in your telescope and how to properly compensate for it. To start this process, you're going to need something that can measure small distances, around 6 inches or 150 millimeters. I use digital calipers. These can measure down to 1/100th of a millimeter, which is about 10 microns. For me to show you how to measure your backlash, it's easiest if we just go to the bench back here.
So, the first step is to run your focuser all the way in. Make sure that it's in 100% and engage your autofocuser. Connect your laptop or other computer and open up your focusing software, which you can see on the screen now. The next thing that you want to do is run your focuser out a certain large amount of distance. I'm going to choose 2,000 steps. And the reason why we're going to run it out 2,000 steps is to take out any backlash that's already here from running it into zero. We want to start from a clean slate. There. So we saw this move a little bit. That tells me that all the backlash is out. Using a digital caliper, we're going to measure how far out the draw tube is, like so. And you might be able to read that. It's 11.9 millimeters. We're going to zero that out. And back in our software, we're going to sync the position to zero. So now the focuser thinks it's at zero. We've taken all the backlash out. Instead of doing 2,000 steps, we're going to do 50,000 steps. That's 5,000. 50,000. Great. Now it's at 50,000 steps. We're going to measure the depth that the focuser draw tube has extended. We're going to be very precise about this. And what I do is I try to square this up with a little lip right here. And then push against here to get the depth probe against this flange. And there we go. And so my depth is, I just bumped that. So you can see the depth is 60.02 millimeters. So we're gonna record that. That is the true amount of distance 50,000 steps will extend my draw tube. With that recorded, we're gonna tell the software to run this back to zero. Now the autofocuser has returned to a place where it thinks it's at zero. So we're going to remeasure that distance. And this new depth is going to have some sort of error in it. It will be a non-zero value. And that non-zero value is my backlash. You can see there, 0.97 millimeters. That down here. So this little log that I've created has 50,000 steps at 60.2 millimeters, and then we went back to zero steps and it's 0.97 millimeters of depth remaining. So that's almost a full millimeter of slop. There could be some measurement error here, so what I recommend doing is repeating this process a number of times. And repeat that as many times as you think is necessary to average out the noise. I'm gonna go probably 5 or 6 times. So let's head over to the computer and I'm gonna show you the spreadsheet that does this calculation for us.
So what you're looking at over here in the spreadsheet are the distances that I measured taking my autofocuser out 50,000 steps and then bringing it back to zero, measuring everything with those digital calipers. And I did 6 runs, and as you can see on the spreadsheet, I've got a couple of averages happening here. So let's dive into that real fast. Here are the 50,000 steps that I ran everything out. These are the various distances that I ran. I've got a couple of low-lying outliers here and a couple of high outliers here. And this is the reason why we want to average, is you're going to get these from time to time. So we want to get the lows and the highs, just kind of average everything out. The resolution is just this divided by that, the resolution. I returned everything back to step 0 on the autofocuser. The depth error here was measured in millimeters, and the backlash comes out to these values, and that's the backlash in steps. This is the backlash in millimeters. And to get this, all I did was divide the depth error by the resolution. This line here has our averages, and the average distance that I measured was 60.03. The resolution was always 0.112, so, or 0.0012. The return to zero was always 0. The average error of depth was 1.18, almost 1.2 millimeters. And that's a lot of slop. And the backlash ended up averaging out to 924.5 steps, but because I can't have a half step, that's 925 steps. So the total backlash here, 925 steps, or 1.11 millimeters. That's a lot of backlash to have to deal with. Fortunately, I can deal with it. I can put these numbers into Sequence Generator Pro, and whenever it runs through an autofocus routine, anytime it has to move the focuser and change direction, it will know to compensate by 925 steps. If I wanted to be a little generous, I could just make it an even 1,000 steps, and it won't matter. So that's what I'm going to do. In Sequence Generator Pro, I'm just going to use 1,000 steps of backlash compensation.
I should probably give me a couple of seconds. Trying to do this all in a single take, but that ain't going to fucking happen. Now, in order for me to show you how to do all of this, it's going to be handy if we do this.